the time for the most famous buffalo cheese in the whole entire universe, and that is the mozzarella.
So today we are making crumb buffalo mozzarella pockets with a caprese salad and chili yam on the side. Yum!
Mozzarella's got an amazing flavor, but at the same time, it's very stringy when it melts, and it's like a transport for other flavors. It makes everything be absolutely amazing.
So first, we are going to make some chili yam to go with it.
Very simple, okay? Spanish onion, a little bit of capsicum, just slightly diced, just little cubes. Okay? And now the capsicum, this red capsicum, so sweet and beautiful. They're gonna balance that amazing acidity. So, okay, so when you use the capsicum, make sure you don't get the seeds inside the jam.
So what did you say?
Don't get the seeds.
Oh, sorry, okay.
So are you gonna help me, or?
You're gonna just be eating the ice cream most of the time.
Sure. What can I do?
Ringo, so we're gonna do a little salad. We got different tomatoes here. Mm-hmm. They're ready to rock. So just arrange some of them in quarters, some of them in slices. Just let your imagination run.
While Chris gets to grips with the salad, I'll go back to my chili jam. In the pan, I've got some chopped chilies.
Seeds in, very important, because even if you think that's too hot, you know, you need the heat. After we're gonna have sugar, it's gonna be amazing.
Add the Spanish onion, capsicum, sherry vinegar, and sugar.
Okay, gringo, so what's happening here? When you cook this for at least 1 or 2 hours, pretty low heat, get the stick blender in there and blitz it all up. And look at how amazing, and you can put that in the fridge. And sugar is a preservative, so you can have it for ages.
Chris's salad is looking delicious. So it's time I start building the magnificent mozzarella pockets.
You get a little bit of butter, spread it, be generous.
So how do you prepare the mozzarella?
We're just gonna grab your knife, get a bowl. This is do big coins.
Big coins?
Like, not Bitcoin, big coins of Bitcoin. Sometimes English can get complicated, isn't it? Like coins of mozzarella like this, okay? And now you're gonna just set them in the middle?
Yep.
Okay, so now what we're gonna do, one, it's like a sandwich of basil, right? Two big basil leaves, one in here, one in there. Mm-hmm. A pinch of salt in each of them. And now the chili yam, I got the one I prepared earlier. A little dollop of this. And now it's all about the ring. Ring of fire. This magic ring. So, because we don't want too much bread on it, we're gonna take the crust away.
This makes it restaurant quality with an interesting shape, doesn't it? Just yeah. Elevates it.
Oh, there you go. See, can you see there?
Sorry, did we just join Spanish play school?
Pinch the side of the pocket like a little ravioli. Then get deep in into some flour, beaten egg,
drop it like it's hot in there,
and breadcrumbs, making sure the pockets are evenly coated.
We got a few of them ready, and I'm gonna get the frying pan that I have in the back, bring it to the heat, and we start frying. Gringo, look at this. Hot oil. This is the moment we've been waiting for.
Fry the pockets until they are golden brown. And while we're waiting, Chris can finish off the salad.
A lot of oil, salt, pepper. You're gonna dress it on the plate. Use some of the glaze. You know we got a really famous glaze in Spain? Julio Iglesias.
You didn't need to slow it down. It was fairly obvious.
I know. It was almost like in a slow motion.
After cooking the pockets for 2 or 3 minutes on each side, this will be ready to rumble.
Oh, look.
Oh, my God. Okay, gringo. Wow. Which one we want to choose? Gringo.
Oh.
Look at these. Look at these, gringo. Ready? Seriously.
Oh. That is so good.
There you go, gringo. So, there you have it. Mozzarella, chili jam, and basil pockets on a just traditional caprese salad.
Thank you to you, but more importantly, amazing work, ladies.